In Microsoft Teams, up in the right-hand corner is either your initials or your picture, but that also includes what status you're in. So right now, Microsoft Teams is saying I am busy. If I hit the drop-down for busy, here's a bunch of statuses you do see available a lot, busy. There's some other ones in here. We're going to discuss the different statuses. I'm also going to discuss duration, reset status, and your set status message right here. Let's go ahead and dive into this right now. So Teams is saying that I'm busy for this reason. It knows I'm in Teams. It's reading my calendar. Your Outlook calendar and your Teams calendar are in sync. And right now, if you notice, on Saturday the 23rd, here we go. I'm supposed to be recording a Teams video on the status feature. And I've already done this other video on sort features in Excel, 7 sort features. So that's why it says that I am busy from my calendar. If I did not have that appointment on my calendar right now, and nothing was on my calendar, it would say that I was available. A cool feature in Teams is you can always go and override this. So it says I'm busy, but let's say whatever it is I'm working on, I really can be free if someone needs me. So I can be working on something, but just go and let people know that I am available. It takes about 4 to 6 seconds to change up in the top right. There it goes. Maybe a little longer sometimes. So now it says I'm available even though I've got something on my calendar. Another cool feature, and I use this one all the time, do not disturb is when I need to work on something. Let's say I got an urgent phone call and I need to work on something. It's going to take me approximately 20 minutes to do it, and it's urgent. If I go to do not disturb, and we just said this, I'm overriding my current status from the calendar. I do not get any notifications in Teams. The one exception to that is if someone at mentions me, I would get that one. But what happens since I overrode this manually, if I forget to turn off do not disturb, it looks like I'm not around all day or can't be bothered all day. So let me just go back and reset status, which I haven't discussed. Reset status goes and looks and finds out exactly what status you're really in. I should pop into busy in just 1 second, by the way. And I just did. The reason is I got that appointment on my calendar. If I didn't have that appointment, I would have gone to available. So going back to that do not disturb, instead of going do not disturb, I still need to be do not disturb, but I'm going to use this duration feature. I use this almost every day in Teams. I'm going to go to duration, do not disturb, and I want to reset my status after 30 minutes. If none of these times work for you, you can come in here to custom. I'm going to go to 30 minutes and hit done. I'm back to do not disturb. After that 30 minute period, Teams will go and do an automatic reset status itself, but in 30 minutes it will. I'm going to go ahead and hit reset status again just to do it one more time. I'm going to go from do not disturb back to busy. Another cool feature you have in here, and I use this one every day, is set your status message. Just so you know this, some of the messages you'll get when you're looking at people may say that they're presenting. That's because they're in a meeting presenting. So you don't see all of them right here, but these are always available. If I need to pop away just for a second, I may do a be right back. Maybe I need to go grab a cup of coffee. But the other feature I use every day is set status message. So in this example, let's say that I know I have a training class from 11 a.m. to noon, and then right after that class, I've got to work on something, and then after that, I'm headed to lunch. So I may make my status message in training until noon, and then unavailable until, I'm making this up, 1:30 p.m. I'm going to just type in test for now. I would have just typed in everything I just said here. Show when people message me. So now when people mouse over me or try to send me a text message, they're going to see oh, Chris is in training and then he'll be available at 1:30. So that's a cool feature, and I'm gonna hit done. So if you turn on your status message, and let's say that whatever I had after my training class at noon, I realize as soon as I'm done, I got an email, I don't need to do that anymore, and maybe I'm going to lunch later. To clear your status message, just come up here, change status. There is how you remove it completely. And here's where you come back in here and edit the message again. You could also come back in here, but I'm just going to clear or delete my status message. Status message has been deleted. Final tip for you about the statuses. We've looked at duration, reset status, where it comes from on your calendar, how to override it. The command bar is up at the top. It says search. Some people call it the search bar. It's also known as the command bar. You can click up here if you want to. The Windows keyboard trick while you're in Teams is Control and the letter E. And then here you go. I've already been doing a few of them. Be right back. /BRB. My status just changed. Click up here again this time, or Control E. DND is do not disturb. It changes. Control E. Available. There you go. So you can change your status from the command bar. I have an entire video on the features of the command bar down in the description. Feel free to go and check that out. My Microsoft Teams training class online is available. Christian and I added some more material this weekend. It is now over 2 hours and 45 minutes. We added a lot of material this weekend. Feel free to check it out. It is still 50% off. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. Any comments or questions, put them down below. Have a great weekend. Thank you.